April 2017 marked the 100th anniversary of a pivotal battle in the First World War, involving thousands of Canadian troops, including hundreds of Indigenous. Many Métis were among them who had eagerly signed up for active duty when called upon.
The Canadian military wants you. A special call has gone out to Métis and Indians of Saskatchewan to join the cause to help stop the German offensive in Europe.
Métis, some still in their teens, decided to enlist, despite the fact many of their ancestors were forced to fight for their rights in 1716 at the Battle of Seven Oaks, and again against federal soldiers at the Battle of Batoche in 1885. Just 30 years later, the government was coming to them, asking for help. They left their tiny remote communities and either walked or paddled hundreds of kilometers to sign up, not as Métis, but as Canadians or French, to join a war in a far-off land for a country that had shown little respect for the Métis. Historians describe the Battle of Vimy Ridge as a defining moment for Canadian forces as they fought bravely to take control of the German-held high ground. A tiny plot of soil, not more than a few football fields in size, Vimy Ridge, held by the Germans since 1914, was considered a key stronghold during the First World War. The French tried to capture it in 1915, then the British in 1916. Sitting merely meters away from each other, hunkered down in a series of trenches, the two sides took turns taking pot shots at each other. It was a battle of attrition. The only break in the fighting usually came on Christmas Day, when the two sides agreed to a truce to enjoy a few hours of peace. Young soldiers would use the quiet to reflect. President Chartrand was given a knife which was handcrafted out of bullet shells by a soldier named A. Mackey, whose name was etched into the handle along with the name Vimy, Hill 70, dated 1917. The knife was found in a field, and President Chartrand was asked to take it back to France to return it to its rightful owner.
But again, this is an example of our soldiers who are trying to find some kind of sanity during this time of hell, as I said, during the Battle of Vimy and Battle of Hill 70. So they would actually carve out different things and using whatever is in front of them. And these were used by the shell casing of their bullets. So again, it's a good example of great artistic work, firstly, but a treasure here for the family for sure.
On April 9th, 1917, four Canadian divisions stood up to take their turn at Vimy, determined to once and for all swipe the ridge from enemy forces. However, it came at a terrible cost. In just 4 days, more than 10,000 young Canadian soldiers were killed or injured as they trampled through the mud and the misery toward a relentless German force hidden just over the next ridge. Today, deep trenches remain as a dismal reminder to visitors of what happened decades earlier, along with a white marble memorial that stands atop Vimy Ridge to honor those 3,598 Canadians who made the ultimate sacrifice 100 years ago.
They had boots lined up all across the areas of the hill itself, and where they displayed the amount of boots per soldier that was killed with a poppy.
David Chartrand, as the minister responsible for veterans, represented the Métis Nation at the ceremony.
The point of going to Vimy was to show the world that the Métis were there. These warriors were there, these buffalo hunters were there, these expert marksmen with the rifles, and in fact they have it in the museum, that Indigenous people, particularly Métis and First Nation, were used a lot as snipers.
President Chartrand was among First Nations and Inuit leaders. However, he found the activities fell short of truly recognizing Métis contributions to the cause.
That struggle still exists. It's unfortunate. Even though 100 years earlier, they called upon us to help the world. And for some reason, they have a hard time recognizing the Métis Nation.
President Chartrand believes the world saw the Métis contingent on hand, and it was a good learning experience for all, including the 10,000 youth there to hear about the past and share their experience.
And to see firsthand where this battle took place, all the holes are still there, the hills are still there, and the trenches are still there where he dug underneath.
Walking along military graveyards, President Chartrand couldn't help notice how well maintained they were. The trees and grass groomed and in pristine condition, and row upon row of headstones, a brilliant white. Leonard Morin from Saskatchewan joined President Chartrand in France and was happy and relieved to find the gravesite of a fallen uncle. a lasting symbol, courtesy the French, Belgians, and others, of the enormous respect and appreciation they continue to show the Allies, including Canada. To this day, since the end of the First World War, in the small Belgian community of Ypres, close to Passchendaele along the French border, residents come together at 8 p.m. to hear the last post. One and all are invited to join with them for their daily homage to the fallen, to pray, to stand side by side, not as brothers in arms, but as partners in song, remembrance, and thanks.
Reflect back, 100 years is not a long time, but it changed the world. And so I'm proud as a Métis minister that our people helped change the world, and our people helped find freedom.
When Métis veterans returned to Canadian soil from battle, many were told to simply go home with no compensation or support. President Chartrand says it's a struggle for recognition that continues to this day.
We won the war, but we lost the battle, because at the end, the Métis still suffered and brought it home with them, and it affected their families, it affected their lives, and some of them drank themselves to death after, and because there was no support for them.
To honor Métis veterans, a series of memorials are being erected across the Métis Nation homeland in places such as Batoche, Saskatchewan, and eventually in other Métis communities, including Duck Bay, Camperville in central Manitoba. They're lasting reminders to young and old never to forget.
I want people to see why we must always respect our veterans. And even today's veterans that go out to war, there's so much that we just can't maybe fathom because we don't see it, we don't feel it, but the things that they have to go through. So, you know, that's why it's important when you see a veteran, you know, stop and say hi and stop and say thank you.